Well, greetings to all the viewers of podcast radio and stuff. It is me, just relaxed today, as just a layman, as an ordinary South African, thinking about izinto ezikade zenzeka in South Africa for the past 7 days. You know, so I just want to give some of my views as a layman. You know, I'm not an analyst, but I'm a citizen of this country, and I have an interest kwizinto ezenzakalayo and izinto ezisuke zikurrent. So today, being a Saturday, we are ending our week, and for the past 7 days, it's been an eventful period in South Africa. On Sunday night, silalise siyazi iCabinet yase South Africa is announced by our president, uPresident Cyril Ramaphosa. It's been the longest waiting for uPresident ukuthi announce iCabinet yakhe. So it's cut between the inauguration of the president kanjalo nokumenyezelwa kwalabo azosebenza nabo bayi cabinet yakhe. So lokho kwenziwe ukuthi iSouth Africa is forming a government of national unity, GNU in short, and it was for the first time in the history of South Africa ukuthi the ruling party we ANC ithola amavoti up below 50%. So they had to find a way ukuthi how are they going to do things moving forward, and we know ukuthi EDA was one of the parties that was difficult for them when it comes to our negotiations. And I can imagine, I'm not a politician, but those were very tough negotiations. But yeah, finally, we do have a cabinet in South Africa. It is now time for us to see, Ubuti, will this cabinet work for us again? Now remember, we are going to be paying for this cabinet. And this is the biggest cabinet in the history of South Africa since kwaqala democracy, esibhekene nayo. And the fact and the truth is that we are going to pay for this cabinet. And the question is, are we going to get the value for money when it comes to this big cabinet under the government, a government of national unity? Now, only time will tell. I'm not the one who will be able to tell, but it is time that will tell. Come December, which is 6 months from now, we will be in the position to be able to say, are we getting value for money? Are we not getting value for money? Now, there are portfolios engibene interest kubona kakhulu when I was looking at a cabinet ka president. And I must say, now ngiyazi ukuthi unawakho owabhekile ofuna ukubona ukuthi azofunctiona kanjani and azosinikeza any value for money. Perhaps you can even share those with me ukuthi wena imapha wakho owabukayo. But for me, number one, right at the top, ile yakwa Department of Education, Department of Basic Education, rather. Now, Department of Basic Education is one of, for me, the key departments for any country. And now this department is going to be under a minister or belong with Democratic Alliance. And the new minister, the Department of Education, ubhekene ne-challenge enkulu. Why do I say so? Ubhekene ne-challenge enkulu ukuletha i-transformation kwi-education system yethu e-South Africa. There's something that I strongly believe in, ukuthi as South Africans, we need to prepare abantwana bethu abafundayo for the real world. Because I believe ukuthi i-education system yethu esithola ingane zethu njengamanje does not prepare them for the real world. What do I mean by that? Iquestion engicela uzibuze yona, i-education etholwa abantwana bethu e-South Africa, ngabe iyamenza yini umntwana ukuthi angasuka la e-South Africa aye e-China afika survive? Iyamenza yini umntwana ofundela e-South Africa ukuthi angaya e-States, United States of America, afike a-survive? Angaya in any country in Europe, afike a-survive? And from where I am seated, I think no, that is not what our education system is doing. It is doing, to a certain level, a disservice to abantwana bethu. You know, the education system here in South Africa is not even educating abantwana bethu to be innovative, because If we are to own the future as South Africans, we need ukuthi abantwana bethu at grassroots level bafundiswe innovation, ukuba innovative. Even today, mangabe singena e-mall, think of i-mall yangakini in South Africa, uyobheka just a cell phone, a gadget that almost everybody has. You will find ukuthi in the entire mall, wonke ama cell phones adayiswa lapho are imported. They are coming from China and many other countries of the world. Now, if we are going to continue to import izinto ngendlela esizimporta ngayo, it means we do not have innovators in South Africa. It means we are not owning ama means of production, but we are only consumers of ama products. And the only way we can become ahead and change our status quo as a country is ukuthi we begin to own our means of production, we begin to produce innovators. And this cannot be achieved by a politician who goes into office and a plan for 5 years, because most politicians, they are worried about 5 years because they are going to be in office for 5 years. This needs umuntu ozokwazi ukuba ne 20-year, 25-year plan, because yinto ekumele siqale sazi ukuthi we are producing innovators. So the new minister really, really has a challenge ahead of her that I'm throwing to her. Ukuthi, minister, perhaps this is what you need to look at. How are you going to transform our education system and produce innovators, and also from grassroots level, and also produce learners at matric level who can go anywhere in the world and be able to survive? But on a lighter note, I was laughing when I was looking at the appointment of this minister, because I'm reminded ukuthi uZodwa Zwane, oy deputy chairperson ye SATU in KZN, ngesikhathi kukampaignwa and he campaigned for the 29th May elections, yayiheated and hot. Kune clip yakhe engayibona ekhuluma ethi, just imagine iDepartment of Education ingaphansi kwa MEC was not an ANC. Just imagine upremier wethu kungayona ANC. And now I'm just laughing because unfortunately for uDeputy Chairperson weSathu, njengamanje lawo mazwi akhe awakhuluma useyawaphila, ngoba iKZN ingaphansi kuka premier who belongs to the IFP. Nationally, a Department of Education ingaphansi kuka minister we DA. So let me hope ukuthi they are prepared and ready to work with the Democratic Alliance at a national level, and ready to work with the IFP at a provincial level as the premier of the province. So that is the Department of Education that I have been so interested in. The second department, engidonsele amehlo, the Department of Public Works and Infrastructure. Le department ibikade iholwa umhlonishwa uSihle Zikalala. He's a former premier of KZN, and then after ephumile as a chairperson of the province, ngokwe political party yakhe ANC, he moved to the national government. Now, useshintshiweke uBaba Zikalala, njengamanje use deputy minister. And uSihlalo we Democratic Alliance in the province of KZN, uDean McPherson, use u minister wale department, we Department of Public Works and Infrastructure. It's a very interesting one. I was listening to u minister Dean McPherson ekhuluma ngolwesine ethi ama ministers noma nje ama members of the executive in government abakhohlwa ukuthi kuzoba nobukhazikhazi obuzoba khona. Akukho mabhilidi amasha azothengwa, akukho imizi emisha azothengwa, akukho mafenisha azothengwa. So basically ubekade ekhuluma ngokuthi he is going to be making sure ukuthi ama expenses, there's going to be no unnecessary expenses. So already he's giving them a stern warning, and he's been firm ukuthi this is what they are to expect. And I'm looking forward ekuthenini le department izosebenza kanjani, especially ngoba masikhuluma ngeprovince yakwaKwaZulu-Natal, between iDA and ANC politically kune rivalry enkulu. Siyazi ukuthi kulama elections esiphuma kuwona iDA beyifuna le province, and this is the home province for uDean McPherson kanjalo nomnumzane uSihle Zikala. How is going to be the working relationship yabo izobukeka kanjani? So that is another department that I'm looking at. But also I'm asking myself ukuthi leto lokuminister kanti upresident uyikhetha kanjani? So umuntu okade a minister usey deputy, which is a demotion. So ube kanjani deputy? Does it mean ubengenzi kahle noma I compromise ekufinyelelwe kuyona yini politically? It's not the only department engiyibukile ngoba ne department of health ngibone a similar thing happening but within the ANC ke now. Umnumzane u Aaron Matswaledi is a former minister of department of health. Usebuyile ke manje again usey minister. And then umnumzane u Joe Phahla ubekade a minister kwi administration ephelile. Uyena owathatha isihlalo sobuminister ngesikhathi uDokotela Uzweli Mkhize eshini. Now ngiyayibuza ukungena kukamnumzane Aaron Matswaledi as the minister, does it mean umnumzane uJoe Phahla was just a caretaker noma kusenzeka leya nto eyakhulunywa ubamkhawula we-EFF ukuthi kuyathunywana nje? So ngenxa yokuncipha kwey'khali bezikhona bekufanele kwenziwe indlela ethile ukuthi woza Aaron sikufaka lana Joe Phahla, but we also still need you so kulungile iba I deputy minister. So you begin to ask yourself these questions. I know very well ama politicians ahleze ethi indaba yokuba I minister that's a political position. You do not need to have an expertise kule department oyinikezwayo. But it's very interesting ukuthi uthathe umuntu onjengo ANG Motshekga okade leader I Department of Education usuthi useyo leader u Department South African National Defence Force amasosha. It's total opposite from basic education to amasosha. But obviously sizotshela ukuthi no, awudingi ukuthi ube umuntu waba owakwaba kwi army. It is a political position, so it means it's just oversight. Mhlambe nami ngingabizwa nje ngizodlala I oversight role. But ngifuna ukuyivala le GNU manje. It's very interesting for me to mangabe ngicabanga ukuthi come 2026 siya kuma local government elections. Is the ANC ready yini ukuthi ibone izimbangi zayo politically zisebenzisa ama positions abanawo njengamanje kuhulumeni to campaign for elections? Ngoba iqiniso lithi ama politicians if they have positions in government bayawasebenzisa ama positions abo in government to campaign for elections. That's a given. Even leaders in the ANC do the same thing. So it means umuntu onjengo Dean McPherson uzoyisebenzisa isikhundla kusona njengamanje parliament ukukampaigna for iDA. Umuntu onjengo John Steenhuisen olidu agriculture uzowusebenzisa lo mnyango to campaign for the DA. As we know isisho se-DA ebesikade sisetshenziswa siza kuma elections ka-2024 besithi DA makes things happen. So now are they not going to be making more things happen to make sure ukuthi in 2026 they are able to gain votes using ama positions abakona? Something to think about and be interesting. In KZN, IFP ihleli esihlalweni sika premier, ihleli kwisihlalo sakwa COGTA. And umuntu olida u COGTA ungundu nankulu wesilo samabandla onke inkosi uMsiZulu. And then mangabe siya nationally, IFP again iphete isihlalo sika COGTA ngaphansi kuka baba uvele inkosini Hlabisa. Now we know very well ukuthi IFP ithanda kanjani mayisebenzi sisondelane nabaholi bendabuko. Is the ANC ready to see the IFP using these positions to gain votes, especially kwiindawo ezinabaholi bendabuko? Let us watch and see. The GNU has just started, and for people who love to observe politics like yourself and myself, we are about to be excited and to see what is really happening. Before I go, Hey, abantu bathande ezemidlalo khona okwenzekile kuleli sonto, especially kwiqembu le Mamelodi Sundowns. Earlier on kuleli sonto kube nama rumors ukuthi umnumzane Rhulani Mokwena oqale kwi Mamelodi Sundowns a co-coach, he's leaving in Mamelodi Sundowns. I thought it was rumors because I think he has had a successful season, but it turned out to be not rumors. He actually left the team. I think he left the team after producing some very good results. Unama PSL Cups out 4, a winner in the Premier Soccer League, out 2, ube co-coach, out 2, ube like I say head coach, and this year, uwine I league le yase Africa okokuqala ebeqala ukuthi iba khona iqale ngayo ukuthi iwin. It's been a very interesting journey for him in Mamelodi Sundowns, and mawubuka iBafana Bafana abadlali abaningi kade begijima khona basuka ngaphansi kwesandla sakhe ngoba bebesuka kwi Mamelodi Sundowns, and now he's no longer part of Mamelodi Sundowns. I don't know where he might be going. We might see him going to Europe. We've got some coaches ally South Africa who are abroad, who are part of ama coaching team in big teams abroad, and I think it would be good for him if he could get an opportunity abroad. But I don't know how Mamelodi Sundowns fans feel about to come back to Rhulani. Maybe you are a fan of Mamelodi Sundowns. How do you feel? Rhulani Mokwena is no longer the head coach of Sundowns. I know Mangoba Mngqithi will be taking care of things for now until the management of the team decides ukuthi kwenzakalani. Does he takes over as the head coach noma kwenzeka ngenye indlela balanda omunye umuntu? But that is something that is very interesting to watch, especially for people who love sport. I'd like to end with this one. Well done to the SABC for keeping up with iSikhathi, the South African Broadcasting Corporation, which is a public broadcaster yala in South Africa. On Thursday, I was listening to SAFM and I heard bechaza ukuthi ba-upgrade kangakanani, be-upgrade i-SABC Plus app yabo, ekwi app yabo yasefonini. I do have the app, and the good thing about this app is that you can listen to radio on the app, you can watch TV on this particular app, and they are improving the app to make the app more user-friendly and to make the app even a more interesting things in it. Even more features, if I may put it like that. So that is what they are doing, which means they are moving with the times. Remember now, iTV akusafanele si access nje odongeni lasekhaya. Iradio akusafanele si access emotweni nasendlini kuphela. People have cell phones, so people want to have an app and you are able to access a radio station yase Cape Town, yase Goli, use Durban. People can watch a news channel on their cell phones from the comfort of their office. If there is a breaking story, they don't need to wait to get home. And people are now watching ama podcast because ama podcast are on their fingertips. That is why you are watching the PRS right now. So for the SABC to show Woody, they are working hard to be keeping up with the times. I think Leo Idina Woody si shayle ihlombele khulu. So that is it from me today when it comes to the layman's view. Please don't forget Woody, you like this page, we podcast radio and stuff. You also tick like so more people can watch this video, and you also share with your friends so they can also comment. Please don't forget to comment. We will interact with you every Saturday in the morning. We just give you our views. Myself and Dobeko Khuluse, it's just lay people. Tomorrow in the morning, it's a beautiful Sunday when you wake up at 9 o'clock. Don't forget to watch our episode. We've got the great and the lovely Nkosinathi Mshengu from Ukozi FM. He's well known as Dr. Love. So tomorrow we'll be having a great interview with him right here on podcast radio and stuff. Remember, this is podcast radio and stuff, South Africa's next biggest podcast. Have a great one.